Right, let's try this again. Same squad, slightly different loadout. I gave more people medkits. Same location, but I think the map will change. Also, let me make a save here. Right, so as the previous episode, this one is one of those where I take the in-game people. Plug them into my work in progress writing schemes, and that's basically I try out scenarios and names and whatnot. And right now I'm simply doing my plotting while little toy people are running around in my presence. Oh, okay, so here's one meld right away. I would say that this setting fits my work in progress much better than the previous one. Like, atmosphere wise. And the fictional situation would be that characters who have been in the early stages of building a long-term base at the, what shall I call it? Oh, let's get you there right away. At the backside of their homeworld's moon, because reasons, a bunch of them go on a mission within mission while doing that, and they're gonna take a little extra trip somewhere that is not too far away, but yet would be unattainable for them through their normal travel. They will be taken there by the person who is organizing the whole mission in the first place, and when picking the characters for that, the logic would be that it will be a quite fully equipped squad with a bunch of fighters, support person, somebody to do the medicing, somebody to do the communications. All this at the same time, the bigger units' leaders are staying in their main site, So basically, there will be like its own little hierarchy within this this setting. Not everybody from the XCOM people has the fictional name, so with most of them I have substituted their surnames with my story folks' names, but not everybody. Ooh, I love this canyon map. I knew where the second doodad is. It's probably somewhere in the hull, I'm guessing. And as with all such games, I'm basically treating the XCOM reality as virtual exercise in universe. Oh, she has the flight too. I keep forgetting. Oh, and one aspect I need to remember during all this is that while I've been leveling up my buggers left and right, I have taken some not so experienced guys on this mission, so there is that. So here we have our POV character. So that's why she's along, because somebody has to witness it. Here we have one of the fighters. Presumably one who knows many of the others. So one thing that I'm giving more consideration than during the first story is which folks know others better, or who knows whom. And I will sort of speculate that since this mission is like it's an extra thing, and everybody is volunteering to go along, then the people who know each other better would be more likely to go together. And the people who have second thoughts about the whole mission, or who have some issues with others, those are more likely to stay behind in the main camp and do the main camp stuff. I have no idea where the other dude at is. Where did he go? Oh, he's still there. Stay there. Right, and she has plot-related reasons to be where she is. Mm-hmm. just you're going in for some recon. Okay. Ooh, we have some nice, like truly nice time limit there as well. Let's bring you here. And I think we're gonna do some ghosting. You, I think it over here, yes. Say that the whole sort of derelict mood suits what I'm aiming at with the story very well. But there it goes. By him, bitch. Targets within range. Why does it show target then? I think it's glitched out a little bit. Yes, you are. Okay, let's leave you where you are. And you. Position you in a better position, such as here, and now you, okay, you do you, and you throw us a thingy. Dude, to move over here. So, everybody, oh, nice. But I want you to move closer to the others. disappear on me now. Surprise mechanics. Okay, who else has a shot? I want the quote unquote rookie in this context to have a chance to. Actually, come here. Let's ruin your weapon. I don't know who has the extra sense, but somebody has. So here we have some bad guys. You reload. I think I should bring you guys on this over to this side as well. Sniper has some as well. Why, hello there. Again. To reload. first get to Overwatch. Take a peek. Like, they don't have any cover here. But like high ground and such. Ourselves and then hide again. Okay, now you've done it. We are throwing a beacon. So this doesn't count as cover. But why? No, not this. This. Now, about them others.
was a little bit weak. He is already wounded, so I don't want to put him into too much danger. Right now is that she is no longer, I mean this guy is no longer on Overwatch. Well, that's not good. The other one, and what's the other one? No, this. No, wrong dude. Ugh. You do. Your turn, I suppose. Instead. Ah. Oh, that was easy. The flush with pistol. That's Oh, he has a medkit, so 0.1. Let's bring him next to the other. Oh no. Get yourself fixed up.
Yeah, that's good.
Beacon. Focus on this side of the ship, because I mean, if there are more guys on the other side, then we will find out soon enough. But I don't wanna cross all this hall just yet.
No, wait, what? Oh, okay. That's not what I meant, but that's not as bad as the alternative. So the wonky 3D strikes again. remains, probably an ethereal, is at the front end of the ship. Spot, but we have already cleared this part, so just bring you back here. Definitely the ethereal sound. Okay, let's do another little save here. Let's bring my people together. Actually, but need to wait another turn. You stay there, don't touch a thing, reload. Anything. Now
a super good position, but so they see them, goody. Oh no! Something tells me you are not fine. Oh, okay, she didn't have a shot. Friendly now. Okay, much better. I think I would like you to come forward somewhat. Maybe you can earn a promotion or something. This time around went a lot better than the first time around. Good simulation, you guys.
Anywho, I don't think I figured out anything about the work in progress, but maybe my brain did. Either way, thank you very much for watching. I might record more of these. Maybe not. I don't know. Anywho, see you then. Bye!